The Hubble Space Telescope was put in orbit in the spring of 1990, and there was tremendous excitement. It was very well publicized. People were really looking forward to learning the new secrets of the universe. And so when it turned out that it couldn't focus properly, I mean, people who didn't live through that era, it's hard to imagine what a disaster it was for NASA, but also for the astronomy community. I'm Jeff Hoffman. I was a NASA astronaut. I made 5 flights on the Space Shuttle, probably the most noteworthy of which was repairing the Hubble Space Telescope back in December of 1993. That was around the time when NASA was trying to convince Congress to start funding for what would eventually become the International Space Station. And as you can imagine, Congress was not very happy with NASA. First, we had to figure out what went wrong, and finally we did. It had to do with the misplacement of the device which actually measured the shape of the mirror when they were making it, so that the mirror was slightly too flat. Plus, there were many other things that had gone wrong with Hubble. The solar panels weren't working right. There was a bad fuse and so on. About a dozen different things, and when they actually analyzed it, it was going to take 5 spacewalks in one mission, which NASA had never done. I got the word that I was selected, and then it was a whirlwind year. The training for the Hubble Space Telescope rescue mission was extraordinary. Anything that anybody could think of to reduce the risk of failure. I mean, I would be in the water tank one day and, you know, I would say, you know, if this wrench had a 20-degree bend in it instead of a 10-degree bend, I could probably get it on a little bit easier. You know, most of the time they'd say, well, deal with it. But no, this was Hubble. The next week we come into the water tank and there's the 20-degree bend. So it was extraordinary working on the Hubble rescue mission.
The crew of the Space Shuttle Endeavour returned to Earth early this morning. They landed at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida just before 12:30 a.m. Eastern Time.
People saw us on television, but that work would have been absolutely impossible without incredible efforts by thousands of people. You could go anywhere in the world, and if you ask a typical person on the street to name a telescope, it would probably be Hubble. Hubble has given us such insight into the birth of stars and also the death of stars. Hubble really has changed the way we look at our universe. It's been extraordinary.